Hello all, so here I am. I'm at the bottom of the pass of the Kettle. Just about to do the climb, no big deal. I just want to say before I go up this big hill, apparently it's the highest climb or whatever in Scotland or Britain, I don't know. Anyway, if you'd have been here 5 minutes ago and seen what I saw, all these pumped up men on their bikes, all revving their bikes like hell before they climb this big hill. Come on guys, for God's sake, like how old are you? You know, probably got small cocks or something, I don't know. But, I mean, I'm tracking down past, thank you for that. But yeah, clearly you're going to go up it, and clearly you're going to go down it. And there's me sat here, them laughing at me on my 9-horsepower Honda Innova. But it's all about fun, isn't it? So anyway, rant over. It wasn't really rant, a bit of a laugh at them, actually. We're just going to see, will a Honda Innova go up and over the Pass of the Kettle? I'm told it starts here. We shall turn left and we shall see. I'm just going to reach over, turn the other GoPro on. By the way, it's raining hard, so probably it'll be really wet. Oh, and by the way, Honda, get the check in the post, yeah? Get the check in the post, because I've got free advertising here. And reverse your decision not to import the Wave to UK after 2017. Ridiculous. It's not as like me the world needs that are going to do the Pass of the Kettle, for God's sake. Google it, Honda. Google it and see. See how passionate people are about Cubs still, yeah? The C90, the Innovas, the Waves. Just Google it. Do yourselves a bloody favour and have a look, right? And you'll see what nutters like me. I've been all in Scotland on this bloody bike. And you, oh, well, no, we're not going to import anymore because it's not very popular. We have an automatic. Ran over again. Let's crack on. Will a Honda Innova go over the Pass of the Kettle? I reckon it will. So we'll see. Lights on. Yada! Off we go. Well, we're out of first gear. I don't know how long this is going to be, by the way. I've no idea. If you get bored or it turns into a wet, rainy, sort of mushy video, just turn it off. Yeah, just cut it off. You don't have to watch it all. I don't blame you. This is Bunny Bandit, by the way. My mum made me this. She made me this for Easter because I was going to go over the Pyrenees, and apparently there's still bandits in the Pyrenees. So we all were taking the Mickey, and mum decided to make us an Easter egg all each with a bunny, and it's Bunny Bandit. He's got a little thing over his eyes. He's got his own little helmet look. Anyway, that's enough about that. I should start the climb. There we go. Third gear, 30 mile an hour, loving it. No big deal. Ah, oh, very courteous. Thank you. Right, second gear. For this, so I hope it's spectacular. So this little Honda's got me on it, which is 18 stone. What's that, about 100, 110 kilo? And I've got 20 kilos of luggage on it for touring. I've been all around Scotland on it. I've got to Applecross. And here we are. I'm not expecting this to shoot up at rocket speed. I don't really want to do it at rocket speed. I think it's all right. I don't think we got there yet, mind. Way to go yet. these Scottish roads, you never quite know what's around the next corner. So you've got to change now. You can't just rally it round because you don't know what's over the edge or... So you have to change down. That's not the bike struggling, by the way. There you go, look. It's revving out in second now. Here we go again. What's this? Edge here, you're going straight down. Now I'm not bloody joking either. I mean, that's all right, it's not a million miles down there, but you wouldn't want to fall down there. You're going to get hurt. I mean, my track record of broken bones, that's not good. Clever on the brakes. You've got to really balance your braking power back and front. And everyone's coming down in front of me, so I'm having to pull over in the passing place a minute. A little wipe for the camera. We'll let the truck come down, then we'll try and make a run for this. It does look steep, I've got to say. Okay. Thank you. Yep. Right, off we go then. We're going to sit here for ages if not. Oh, rough gear change. Come on. Post some messages. Oh, criticise my driving style. Come on. First gear, here we go. some biggie, biggie mountains the last few days, but this is very steep. Thailand, that's where it comes from. His face. He just cycled up that, I reckon. Come on, little Honda. Up into the clouds. Come on, little Honda. You can do this. Make all them people in the factory proud. Well, it's just about to go up into the clouds now. It's really misty. I can see the road clearly. No drama. But I can't see anything else. And it's a little bit weary of what's coming down. Nothing at the moment. I'm just going to take it steady now. Oh, here comes a car down. Right, has he seen me? In place. Ooh, that's right off the edge there. Not too much of a drop down, but you wouldn't want to fall off the edge there. You're going to break an arm or a leg at least. You break your head. I don't know what you could see now on the video, but it is a whiteout up here. I climb up. Up, up, up. Not so steep now. Bike's fine. Pull it nicely. Absolute whiteout fog and cloud. I'm just going to go really steady here. I very much doubt on the video you'll see very much at all now. You might be able to see stuff. Oh, there's someone here. There's a bike. Germans again. All week long I've been seeing these Germans. They keep coming and going wherever I am. Ah, der ist der Scootermann. Ah, yeah. Ah, wo sind denn Applecross? Yeah. Oh, hello, what's this? Oh, we got a set of lights in front of us now. That is a sheer, no it's not, no, I thought it was a sheer drop. Going to stop here in case he decides to back up actually. Thank you. You go first. No, you go first. I don't want to go around. I'm signaling. I'm staying. You go first. Thank you. Now I've got a convoy, a Volvo XC90, I think it is. It's big anyway. mega proper. See much, and I can't really see much today. This is the ziggy zaggy bit, I believe, coming down on the Loch Carron side. I think it's Loch Carron. Say this little bike has been brilliant all the way around Scotland, and obviously I'm coming down the west coast now. I'm going on the Isle of Skye next. When you're coming down hills like this, you do have to balance your brakes very well. You can't give too much on the front without keeping that tail tidy with the rear brake, obviously keeping it in line. And of course you're needing to use the gearbox, what braking you get from that semi-automatic gearbox, but it's fine. And it's been really, really good fun. It's been a great friend on this trip. What I might do is, if the weather's better tomorrow, I'll post this video up anyway, but if the weather's better tomorrow and it's clear, I might take the 50, 60 miles back here and have another go maybe. Just let him through a minute. Okay. Thank you. He's chickening out. Okay, right, I'll go first then. Right, I think we better pull in here. There's something coming up the hill. Like now, look, when you're going down the hill, you've really got to balance your brakes well, because you don't want to skid and you don't want the back end to go out. He's pulling over. Okay. I'm carrying on down. I really can't take my hands off the handlebars now to wipe the lens of the camera, so I'm hoping that it's still alright. Might not be, who knows. I'm going to just pull over a minute, put this guy through. Give it a wipe a little bit there, that might help. Maybe not. So just going to pull in a second. Unfortunately, it's raining. There we go, little wipe of the lens. Check behind, lifesaver. Off we go. Spectacular view. Sorry for the tissue wipes on the screen. Just hope we can improve the quality a little bit for any Honda Cub enthusiasts.
Oh, any Honda Cub enthusiasts? Oh yes, baby, it's been around. Your spark plug? No.
Right, we're almost out now. Go around this corner. Yeah, you wouldn't want to go off the edge there. Wittering on hasn't spoiled it for anybody, but it's been fun. I've been looking forward to this. Big part of my holiday. Nice and steady now. Quite a bit to go yet. Position 2, dogs talk. The wipe again. There, you're just getting a bit of a blast on, and then the corner turns, and it's quite sharp. You've got to give it anchors, and you just don't know what's around the corner. Wave them through. Come on, come through. Wipe the lens. Thank you. Off we go. Shoulder check. This guy round. Oh, there we go, he's round. Ah! If you haven't, I think think the Honda did well. I don't think it struggled really particularly. I'm not going to get all geeky or nerdy. I'm just saying, you know, can you go over the pass of the cattle on a Honda Innova 125? The answer is yes, you can. And it wasn't really stressing either. It wasn't like I was crawling in first gear. So, can a Honda Innova do it? I've said so many times, haven't I? Yes, it can. There you go. Over and out. Enjoy. Later.